Well, Daley Thompson as far away from Jürgen Hinkson as he could possibly be. The two big names in the outside lanes.
Set.
Well, for the third time of offering, and Thompson way ahead at the moment on the near side. Daley Thompson steaming ahead, and Kratzmer coming into second place. Kratzmer and McStravick's done well. 10.45 is good.
Poised as ever.
Accelerating. Oh, it's another fine, fine jump. And yet he was back on the board. That really could have been over 8 metres. He's jumped into a headwind. Watch this. We just caught up. 8.01 he's got, and watch his foot on the ball. Watch this. He just reaches it. He had inches to spare, and he's made 8.01.
The furthest line is 16 metres. And he's close to it. He wanders and ambles out of the back of the circle, but he has got a white flag and he allows himself a smile too. Yes! That is the true competitor.
Eight, and off they go. And Daley Thompson's running down Kratzmer already, and he's gone past him. He's now tracking the big fella, Jürgen Hinkson. Hinkson's holding on very strongly. These two, but Thompson goes past him now. Can Thompson push and punish himself all the way to the line? And Hinkson's head is back, but he's still running fluently. And Thompson pushing himself to the line. Hinkson's head is going back, but Thompson gets there to the line. 46.98. He's had a marvellous run, but so too did Jürgen Hinkson.
There.
Ventures away well, and Thompson are going well, so is Hinkson on the near side, but Daly's going well. It's Hinkson ahead of Daley at the moment. Hinkson from Daley at the moment. Hinkson, Vents, Hinkson first, Thompson second, Vents third, and there wasn't a significant margin between the...
But the chips are down for the first time in this competition. His second round throw of 41.24 has whittled away some of that lead of Hinkson's, but he really needs 45 metres, or he's going to have to do desperately well in the pole vault, something like 5 metres 30. It's a better one, it's a better one, it's a better one, it's a better one! Oh, the man comes good, and he's dancing in the circle. For those who gave up on me, he said. For those who gave up, oh ye of little faith, the Iron Man comes through. When the going gets tough, the tough get going.
And Daley Thompson looking to go to as much as 39 points ahead of the world record schedule at the moment. Yes, he's there. 5 metres, 1,052. And that makes a total of 7,417. As against the world record schedule at 7.378 that Hinkson set just prior to these games. So he's en route to gold and the world record as things go at the moment, and he's still got something left.
I think this is called putting the hammer in when it hurts. He really is the supreme competitor, unbeaten since 1978, and when he was beaten then, well, he cried for 2 days. Watch him pull his knees to his chest and ride this pole well. And now watch him pull with his arms as he senses the bar is near, and he breezes over. Starts to relax, tucks back, and he's grinning already.
A sign of a true competitor.
Just let me throw. And if he can get one in at about 65 metres, it's drifting, it's not bad, it's not bad, it's not bad, it's not bad! That is about 64 metres, and that may well have resolved the gold medal. He's still got a lot of work to do. It could be a personal best in the decathlon. That's a fine throw from Daley Thompson, and he's shown he's in tremendous form all day. Not a very long run-up, Stuart, but off that short run-up, he really is powering it in. 65.24, just short of his best. Will tell us by how much. He's not just going to break the Olympic record, but he's going to break the world record. a demonstration as Hinkson crosses the line. 90 yards ahead of him, Daley Thompson finding a little bit of a sprint, closing the gap on Siggy Vents, and Motti of France closes on him, but he's there. 4:35, that is what he needed to break the world record, there or thereabouts. He certainly smashed the Olympic record of 8.617 that stands to Bruce Jenner. This man was born to do the decathlon.